astronaut is off.
Gravity is about astronauts who get stuck floating through space, and thanks to some amazing special effects, moviegoers get to tag along for their frightening and lonely journey hundreds of miles above the Earth. While audiences are clearly captivated, astronauts and space buffs alike no doubt watched some parts of the movie with smirks and sighs. That's because in typical Hollywood fashion, Gravity at times has all the scientific integrity of Spaceballs. Joining us now live is NASA astronaut Michael Massimino. He's also a visiting professor at Columbia University. And of course, sir, may the Schwartz be with you. Obviously, this is just a movie, so we'd expect Hollywood to take some creative liberties, but you say some parts of Gravity weren't just unlikely, but impossible. Which parts?
Well, when I first started watching the movie, what I was amazed at was the detail, the accuracy of things like the Hubble Space Telescope, the space shuttle, or payload, but even so, some of my tools floating behind Sandra Bullock's head. I was wondering where those tools went, but I guess they use them for the movie. So there's a lot of accuracy in that way, and it does depict the some of the dangers of going into space. So I think I was kind of surprised at all the detail and the accuracy I saw in the detail of the set that they created in the movie.
But what about the part they got wrong? What parts did you watch and think, oh, that's just completely insane?
Well, I think they include, what I'm happy about is that he included not just the space shuttle and the, although we don't fly the space shuttle any longer.
Right.
So that's one thing. I'm glad they included it because it's still part of our consciousness and our space program, at least the history of our space program. And they also showed different places in space. I don't want to give away the movie.
Right.
And in order to include all those things, which I was very happy that they included, you have to take some poetic license, I guess, on how you can easily get around these places. So, again, I don't want to give away too much, but I was pretty impressed with the way that they showed the space environment and our tools. And but yeah, you know, the things that they did, the way they're able to go from place to place, would not be as easy as they showed.
But let's move on to the public policy dimension of this. We're at a time where NASA is facing major cuts. Obviously, there's also the furlough of NASA workers. I think 97% of NASA workers are furloughed. Space program in general being underfunded. And as you mentioned, the space shuttle is no more. Do you think that there's any part of the hype of this movie that could end up drumming up renewed support for NASA or making a whole generation, new generation, interested in space travel?
Jake, I sure hope so. And that's really my greatest hope out of this. We do have people in space. We have two Americans right now, Karen Nyberg and Mike Hopkins. Luca Parmitano from the Italian Space Agency is up there, along with three Russian cosmonauts. It's a great international program. And I think a movie like this really increases people's awareness. So, you know, after you see the movie, go and find out what we're really doing in space, because that's exciting, too. And I think, you know, it's hard for NASA sometimes to get those positive messages out because we're so busy doing our regular jobs that, you know, maybe a movie like this, even though it's somewhat fictional, will increase awareness of what is actually going on in space and hopefully inspire kids. I was inspired by space movies when I was a younger person. I think it's going to inspire a lot of young people as well.
So you're not a film critic, obviously, by training, but give us your final thoughts. You give us a thumbs up or a thumbs down on Gravity.
Okay, as you said, I'm not a film critic, and there's probably a lot of films I like that people would raise their eyebrows about, but I like this one. I enjoyed watching it because I could see a lot of the detail, brought back a lot of memories of my space flights, and I enjoyed it. You know, and I think that it's hopefully going to be a good thing for the space program as well.
Well, that's a ringing endorsement from an astronaut, I would think. I mean, like, I know people in this town, anytime there's a Washington, D.C. movie, we just, you know, because they get this wrong, and they you know, presidents don't introduce legislation, et cetera. But you're an astronaut, and you're saying you enjoy it, and that's good enough for me. Michael Massimino, thank you so much for joining us.
That is it. Thank you, Jake.